Tilakkhana, meditation on the three characteristics. This is real meditation. Tilakkhana, three characteristics. In many Buddhist countries, especially Sri Lanka, Burma, Thailand, Cambodia, every day they go on reciting and reciting and reciting these three for their concentration or meditation to understand, to calm their mind and to forget their worries and disturbances. Very meaningful recital for meditation. Sabbe sankhara anicchati. Yada panyaya passati. Atra nibbindati dukkhe. Esa maggo visuddhiya. Sabbe sankhara anicchati. Yada panyaya passati. Atta nibbindati dukkhe, esa maggo visuddhiya. When one sees with wisdom that all component things are transient, he overcomes misery. This is the path to purity. I strongly advise you to recite this. First you can recite with the book, later you can memorize. When you are free, go on reciting these sayings of the Buddha. First thing, we get some sort of understanding about our life and problems and disturbance. Second thing, we get the chance to calm and train our mind to avoid, to get rid of our unnecessary fear and worries and disturbances. Try again. Sabbe sankhara anicchati yada panyaya passati. Atra nibbindati dukkhe, esa maggo visuddhiya. Here there is one word, yada panyaya passati. Panya, wisdom. We had to see these things by using your wisdom. Wisdom means understanding. You have to think, then you gain understanding. Otherwise, you go simply reciting without thinking deeply, without analyzing, without trying to catch the meaning. Yada panyaya passati, one who sees through his or her wisdom. Wisdom means understanding. What is this? Three characteristics. Anicca, dukkha, anatta. Three characteristics. There are many places in the Buddha's discourse where he mentioned, if anyone can understand the real meaning of these three lakkhana, three characteristics, it is not necessary for that person to learn anything else. in the Buddha's teaching, in Tripitaka. This is enough. Try to understand the meaning of these three. You can say you know whole Buddhism, the teachings of the Buddha. Because the teachings of the Buddha are based on these three characteristics. Anicca, Dukkha, Ananda. Here, Sabbe Sankhara Anicca. Then analyze. All component things are anicca, impermanent, changeable, transient, never remain without changing. Then we can analyze this later. Take one by one, all the existing things in this whole universe, not only in this world. All these things are going on changing, 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 changing. This is called existence. No existence without changing. If there is nothing to change, there is no existence. Existence remains because of these changes. Sabbe sankhara, sankhara. I have explained the meaning of this word sankhara. English word is here component thing. Simply say component thing. Don't know which kind of component things. Compounded component. And this is the definition of the word sankhara. Uppado panyayati, vayo panyayati, thitasya anyatattham panyayati. Definitions of sankhara, component thing. The things that which exist, whether it is life or anything else, the whole universe, including the suns and the moons and the galaxies, any part of the universe, including heaven and hell, including Brahma world and Devaloka, all these things are component. That means changeable. Because we think many of them are permanent. Uppado panyayati. We can see the things that come into existence are easy. Life come into existence. We can see, yes, very common. Plant life come into existence. Houses, buildings come into existence. Roads and bridges come into existence. Buses and trains and aeroplanes come into existence. Stars and galaxies, suns and moons come into existence. Now these are visible things. But there are so many invisible things, we cannot see them. There are more invisible things. But all these things are component. Now we cannot see a spirit and ghosts and devils, we cannot see. They do exist. They are also component things. We cannot see devas and brahmas and gods. They are also component. Not permanent. That is what the Buddha said here. Try to understand this. So, things come into existence, we can see. Some others we cannot see. After this existence, what will happen? Titasya anyatattan panyaya. That thing which appeared, we can see how changes take place. Going on changing, 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 changing. At the beginning, we call developing, growing. If it is a life or plant, we say growing, 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 growing. But it is changing. In reality, it is changing. After changing and changing and growing and growing and developing and developing for a certain period, stop this growing. But changes take place again. First went on growing, 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 developing, 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 then stop. Then turn this way. Then going down and down and down, decaying and decaying and decaying and decaying and decaying and decaying, changing. Two ways. First, developing, also changing. Decaying, also changing. So after decaying and decaying and decaying, vayo panyayati, disappear. The thing that appeared, now disappear. No one is free from these three characteristics. Whether humans or animals or ghosts or devas or brahmas or any kind of living being or any galaxies or suns and moons and universes. They appear, they exist, they decay, they disappear. Again appear, reappear. That is how universes exist. Not only one universe. We know only one universe. Sabbe sankhara anicchati. How meaningful it is. This one line. Sabbe sankhara anicca. All those component things are impermanent. Anicca. Changeable. So when changes take place, we can reduce our worries. When we meditate and meditate and meditate, get used to our mind. It's a real meditation to develop the mind. This meditation is to develop the mind, not to damage the mind. Yada panyaya pasati. One who sees through panya, through understanding. When you analyze through understanding, then we can catch the point there. Oh yes, they are like this. Atha nibbindati dukkhe. After that, can get rid of dukkha, sufferings, worries and disturbances. Because we realize the real nature, we realize, we understood. Now we worry and cry because we have not understood. We have not realized. Esamaggo visuddhiya. This is the method for purity, mental purity. Mental purity means final goal, nirvana. Esamaggo visuddhiya. There is no any other method. People believe that praying and worshipping and offerings and they are different practices for different purposes. But never gain purity in our mind by performing all these activities. This is the only way. When we realize all these things are like this, that understanding reduce our worries and fear and disturbances, then the mind gets the chance to relax, to maintain peace, then purity. Next one. Sabbe sankhara dukkhati. Yada panyaya passati. Atta nibbindati dukkhe. Esa maggo visuddhiya. Sabbe sankhara dukkhati. Yada panyaya passati. Atta nibbindati dukkhe. Esa maggo visuddhiya. When one sees with wisdom that all component things are sorrowful, he overcomes misery. This is the path to purity. Only one word here extra, dukkha. The first one, sabbe sankhara anicca, all the component things are impermanent, changeable. Here, all the component things are, what is that? Dukkha. Create dukkha. Miserable. It is true. If we can see through our understanding, through our wisdom, but we cannot understand properly, if we see, if we look at, with our craving. Craving interrupt, block real understanding. That is why we cannot understand. I can give a very, very simple example. When doctors or surgeons want to amputate one hand or leg, what they do? They give anesthetic injection. After this anesthetic injection, they start cutting. No pain. If they cut without giving this anesthetic injection, we feel pain. That anesthetic injection is just like this meditation, to detach. When the mind detaches, reduce that craving, after that no more worries, no more pain, no more disturbances, just like anesthetic injection. So we feel pain because of our craving and attachment, that injection stops that, doesn't allow the mind to experience this, then no pain. So if we really understand this, we can reduce lot of worries. I have told you this incident. There was a well-known British Buddhist scholar who has written a lot of books, Mr. Francis Story. The books written by him, even in our temple you can see, Buddhist Outlook, Diamonds of Buddhist, what you call, Thoughts, many books he has written. He had a very painful sickness, bone cancer, the backbone. Very painful. Taken to England. He was in Sri Lanka at that time. Every 3-4 hours, doctors give him painkiller injection, that's all. When he came to know that his days are numbered now, very close to his death, he told the doctors not to give painkiller injection anymore. Because we always talk about suffering. Always we write books about suffering. But so far, we have not experienced the real suffering. If we experience the real suffering, then easily we can understand the real nature of this life, this body. So allow me to experience this pain. That is Buddhism. I want to concentrate on this pain. Don't stop my pain. So what he did? When the pain comes, he divert his mind toward his pain. Then go on pain and pain and pain and pain and pain by concentrating this. He controlled his pain and he died peacefully, without crying and without worry. That is called see things through wisdom, through understanding. Sabbe sankhara dukkha. All these component things are dukkha, create dukkha. And I told you the meaning of this component thing, combinations of elements and energies, all component thing. When these things separate, dissolve, or disintegrate, that existence is no more. It's easy to understand. So, sabve sankhara dukkha, even plant life also experience this. Dukkha. Dukkha does not mean suffering. There are 3 kinds of dukkha, 3 ways. Dukkha, dukkha, 1 kind of dukkha. Viparinama dukkha, sankhara dukkha, 3 kinds of dukkha. Dukkha, dukkha means pain and ache that we experience in our body. That is called dukkha, suffering. So simple. Stomach ache, headache, toothache, backache, this is dukkha. This is called dukkha dukkha. But there's another one, severe than, stronger than this. Viparinama dukkha. Viparinama means changes. Changes take place, we experience dukkha, suffering. We cannot tolerate it. Worse than backache or toothache. Separate. Your wife separate from you. Your husband separate from you. Your children separate from you. Viparinama dukkha, intolerable dukkha, suffering. Your property and your money, your jewelry separated from you, stolen. Viparinama dukkha, suffering. Your beauty, your complexion, your youth, fading away. Viparinama dukkha, you are not happy about that, suffering, worry. Go and see the mirror and think what to do. Real dukkha. No hope. So, just going on fading and fading and fading away and getting old and old and old, decay, viparinama dukkha. So throughout our life, we have to suffer from these changes. Another one. Sankhara dukkha. When we come into existence as human beings, from the very beginning, from our birth, up to the last breath, nothing but crying. Baby come to this world with crying. No baby come to this world with smiling face. Baby also cry, mother also cry. Mother cry because of pain. Nowadays, of course, also to injection. But it is artificial. This is here natural. So baby and mother both cry. That is how we start our life. That shows the real nature of our life. In fact, we come to this world not with birth certificate, but with death certificate. That means death is sure, certified. This is to certify that this person will die one day. Come with this certificate. It is true. Then start a big battle. Very big battle. Learning from childhood. Learning and learning and learning and studying and going to school and tuition is a real torture. How many years they have to suffer? After learning and learning and learning, then a struggle to find out a job. Also very difficult to find out a suitable job. Then try to find out suitable partner, girlfriend or boyfriend. Also a very big battle. Sometimes commit suicide also. After getting married, they say, we never knew marriage is so horrible. Otherwise we never get married. There are fightings and quarrelings and arguing and every day no happiness, no peace, no satisfaction, no harmony. Every day. Then they produce children. Children are sick. And sometimes children are very mischievous, or sometimes children are mad or mentally retarded, suffering, worry, disturbances. Then we are also getting old, meanwhile. Now we are preparing for the next life, next world. In the end, we also depart from this world by crying. We cry again when we are going to die. Now this is life. What is this? What a big battle. That is what was the dukkha. From the very beginning, nothing but dukkha. Living means fighting with this dukkha, to stop this dukkha, stop this suffering. So, sabbe sankhara dukkha, all these living things, living beings, have to face. And why ache and pains and disturbances? Frictions of elements and elements. Frictions of elements and energies in the body. Sicknesses appear because of this imbalance. Elements and energy. Wind and heat and fluid cannot agree. Friction. Then sicknesses, then pain. This is natural. Who can stop this? God can stop this. Nobody in this world who can stop this. All these things are natural. This understanding, Dhamma, the Buddha, Buddhism, important for us to understand this. The Buddha has clearly mentioned this is the main cause. Not because you have original sin, not because God can come and punish you or the devil come and attack you. This is the real nature. You can understand this, then you know what to do with this life. Sabbe saṅkhārā dukkha, all these problems. Yadā paññāya passati, you can see through your understanding and your wisdom. Atta nibbindati dukkheya, then you can reduce this dukkha, you can get rid of this dukkha. Esa maggo visuddhiya, we see the path for you to maintain purity where there is no dukkha in that mind. Next one. Number three. Sabbe dhamma anattati.
Sabbe dhamma anattati.
Yada paññāya passati. Atha nibbindati dukkhe. Esa maggo visuddhiya. Sabbe dhamma anattati. Yata paññāya passati. Atha nibbindati dukkhe. Esa maggo visuddhiya. When one sees with wisdom that all dhammas are soulless, he overcomes misery. This is the path to purity. Here, he did not use the word saṅkhāra. First two, sabbe saṅkhāra anicca, sabbe saṅkhāra dukkha. Here, we cannot say sabbe saṅkhāra anattā. Saṅkhāra means component thing. There are certain things which are free from component thing, unconditioned. All the other things are conditioned. There are two things which are unconditioned, not component. So these two things are free from dukkha, free from change. Never change and no suffering. Therefore we cannot use the word anatta for that. Anatta means no soul. What are those two things which are free from changes and dukkha? Anybody who can answer this? Cannot. Only two things. Cannot, huh? A space, no beginning, no end, no change. Never change, nothing to change. You can invite Albert Einstein, then he will explain. He is the one who says two things, time and space. In reality, there are no such thing as time or a space, our measurement. So space never changes, no beginning, no end. So there is no soul. The other one is Nirvana. No beginning, no end, no change. It is unconditioned. They are not component. They do not exist due to combinations of elements or energies. Free from these things, of space and nirvana. That is why here say, sabbe dhamma. Dhamma means all those things which are not component, natural. Dhamma means natural things. No elements, no energies. Nature. Natural occurrences. All in all these natural occurrences, there is no such thing as eternal soul. Sabbe dhamma anatta. The belief that people maintain. In heaven there is eternal soul. In Brahma world there is eternal soul. The Buddha rejected this. That is why he says, sabbe dhamma anatta. All these dhammas, free from anatta, free from soul, soullessness. Yada panyaya passati, one can see through wisdom. That means, people believe, after their death, when this component of physical body is no more, that eternal soul remains there. To reject this belief, the Buddha used this belief. There is nothing to remain as eternal soul without this physical body, without any component physical body. Sabbe dhamma anatta. To attain the first stage of sainthood, sotapanna, we had to get rid of this belief. Otherwise we cannot get into the first stage of sainthood. Sakkāya diṭṭhi, vicikicchā, sīlabbata parāmāsa, three things. Get rid of them. First is sakkāya diṭṭhi, belief that there is an eternal soul or self that is remain forever. We have to get rid of that belief. Otherwise, no sainthood. Sabbe dhamma anatta, yada panyaya passati, atha nibbindati dukkheya. Then we can get rid of all our dukkha and sufferings, unsatisfactoriness that we experience in our life. Esa maggo visuddhiya. This is the method, path, to maintain purity, peace in our minds. So I advise all of you, to recite this. After reciting, read the English translation. After reading, think for a while. Then slowly, at the beginning you may experience some difficulties to catch the real meaning. Then slowly you catch the idea. Then you can see some changes in your life. After that, you don't want to grumble, you don't want to take things so seriously, you don't want to fight with others. You can reduce a lot through this understanding. This is real Dhamma, real meditation, not artificial meditation. Yes. 2-1-1. Punyanumodana. Imina punya kammena upajjaya gunuttara achari upakarata mata pita piyamamam suriyo chandimaraja gunavanta narapiche mama raja indaja lokapala cha devata yamo mitta manusaja majjata verikapiche sabbe satta sukhi hontu Punyani pakatani me sukhancha tividangentu kippang papethavo matang imina punya kammena imina uddhisena ca kippahang sulabhe ceva tannu padana cedanang ye santane hina dhamma yava nibbana to mamam nasantu sabbadayeva yatta jato bhave bhave ujjo citto sati panyo sallekho viriyavamina maralabhantu no padam patuncha viriyesume buddhadi pavaro nato dhammo nato aruttamo nato paccheka sambuddho sangho nato taro mamam desottamanubhavena maro pasang labantu maa.